I'm like Michael Jackson, moonwalking in the Calabasas. Y'all, hey y'all. I'm just chilling, vibing, listening to some music. I just want to come here to talk to y'all. I'm probably gonna turn this down. Do y'all know this song? Moonwalking in Calabasas. Y'all, let me tell y'all, my mama was like, my children always know how to play by themselves. Y'all just be chilling on some chill vibes, getting ready to get myself together for my trip, vibing. It's lit. 2022 finna be here. I'm excited. Y'all be smoking my hookah. I love hookah. I don't know about everybody else, but I love hookah. Anybody know me? Yeah. But yeah, I just want to talk to y'all. I want to vibe with y'all. I want to do like talk. Like hookah talk. Like, I really want to do that. What y'all into? Girl, just be talking. Moonwalk through the Calabasas. I'm going to learn how to moonwalk, y'all. I'm going to learn how to moonwalk. Do y'all know how to blow O's? Do y'all know how to blow O's? I be wanting to learn how to blow those little O's. My cousin and them, they be knowing how to blow O's. My friends, they be smoking for real. They be knowing how to blow O's and stuff like that. I be wanting to learn. I can't do it. What we gonna talk about? Let's talk about music. So, I seen this shirt today. It's a good girl with a hood playlist. That's me. I need that shirt. I'm like, I just took some money, man. Y'all, I love Future. Growing up, this I like listen to. If you from Atlanta, like, Rich Kids, Schoolie, I love Schoolie. Y'all, I went to this like drive-in concert. That was fun. Seeing Schoolie. Well, I didn't see him. He was there. I didn't see Schoolie. I had walked up, y'all. I love music. For real. Like, I seen The Weeknd. I only said that because I see that on my TV. I seen The Weeknd. Me and my brother seen him in South Carolina. Y'all, he's really good in concert. Like, he's a performer. Like, I love people who know how to, like, really perform. They know how to put on a show. When Baby was first coming out, like, he was learning how to put on a show. I saw it. Who else? Jeezy know how to put on a show. Like, I done seen a lot of people in concert. It's like my way. I love concerts. I think I seen me on Future in concert too. No. Who did I see in concert? I don't know. I went to this concert. I cannot think. Who did we go see? I think it was Meek Mill. I don't remember. But y'all, that's like me, my vibe, music, all of that. Some new people I'm getting into. Let's see. I love The Weeknd, Future. I like Miley Cyrus too, y'all. I haven't gotten to the wave of Chloe and Haley, but I really like them too. A couple songs by them. I'm not a B fan. I'm a Nicki fan. Put me on to some music. I like NBA YoungBoy. I like a lot of dudes. That's crazy. I like a lot of dude rappers. I'm not hating on the female rap. I don't know. I'm from the South, so like, the hood music is what I like. Y'all know Pee Wee Longway? Mess with him. And when it like old Future hit. Future really don't be putting out songs like that. He be featuring on some people still, but yeah, like him. I think I talked about it. I like Wayne too, old Wayne. I love old Drake. I like old school, Marvin Gaye. Like, being around my grandparents, they put me on to like music like that. Old school music, y'all. Y'all really want to learn how to blow O's? What else? I don't know. It should be chill vibes in here. And I love coming in here and talk to see y'all. I know I did a video earlier. I'm gonna do a video again. Cause I be bored, y'all. When I tell y'all I be going on solo dates, I be doing the solo dates. What else? Like, yo, they just blew a O on video. I wish I could show y'all that. I want to learn. Let's see. No. Y'all had like a little, I was on Snapchat. That's what I be on, y'all. I don't be on Instagram like that. I be on the TikTok too. But I be on Snap. I be on Snap. Let me put y'all up on game. Alright, let me put y'all up on game. So, everybody knows who's on Snapchat. Like, when people don't be on Instagram and stuff like that, y'all better watch out. They be on Snapchat, for real. Like, don't sleep. Don't sleep. I ain't trying to flex out here. Like, people be high stuff. They be on Snap. Like, a lot of people be, like, on the Instagram way, but Snap the way, too. Like, don't sleep. I'm trying to tell you. It's just, I think Snap more private now. It's not that big anymore. It's big to some people. It's not that big anymore. I'm not on Twitter. I don't know. It's just so dramatic on Twitter. Like, I know people be like finding relationships and stuff on there, but it be a lot going on there. I'm not, I do be talking a lot, like I'm talking now, but, I don't like to, like, randomly say stuff on Twitter, so I don't get on. I don't know. I just feel like people be picking and choosing and won't try to figure out what's going on in your life when they come to Twitter, so I just don't do it. I used to be on Instagram a lot, and y'all, my stories would be filled up. But I'm slowing down on it. Y'all, I like no cap too. I like no cap. Somebody, I was at this smoothie spot. A dude put me on to Jakari. I think he's an up and coming artist. I think he got his song No Glocky or Key Glocky or something like that. Or Keep My Glocky. I'm about to play this so y'all can hear it. So, he's an up-and-coming artist. I like up-and-coming artists, too. They be good. Let's see if I can find it. Y'all think my light be changing when I, it's called Keep My Glock, Jakari. I don't think he's a old artist. I mean, I don't think, well, he's not an old artist, but I think he's an up-and-coming. I think when I be touching my remote, it just be changing, or the light's changing on its own. I don't know. Yeah, they changing on its own now. Let's see if y'all can hear it. Y'all, he good. I'm Jakari in this motherfucker. Y'all be having fun by myself. Crazy. Yeah, I don't know. So, like, now I just be, like, entertaining myself. I mean, low. Like, real low. getting his body right. I told y'all, I'm not really, like, setting expectations. Hold on. Because I don't know if y'all can hear me. But I'm not really setting expectations for losing weight with your girl being. I've been out here. I've been dropping. I'm excited for that. Because when I pop out, it's going to be lit. I'm just excited for this new year, y'all. My ears just need to grow up here. But it's okay. We still be it. y'all. Okay, so I know I had said in my other video I want to tap into the real estate. Like, y'all just found out it's a place up the street from my house that do real estate classes. I'm gonna go look into it. I don't know. I know my friend, she does real estate classes right now. She said it's really long, it's really hard. But I think I could do it. I really think I could do it. I want to step into the commercial building. So, y'all, I had said that I want to open a hookah spot. I really love hookah. Like, I love it to the point where I be like, lit. Like, really, really lit. Like, back in... Because I didn't do it as much in college. Kind of more so when I graduated. I told you, like, I don't know, earlier I said... Now I'm gonna cut this man. He's really good. Back in 2017, before, like, I don't even know if Meg was out then. I don't remember. I don't know. But before Meg did the whole hot girl summer, I had a hot girl summer in 2017. So now it's like I'm growing up and finding me, engaging in things that I like to do. I still like to turn up, but it's more so like on a friend vibe, be cool. Hookah and stuff, I can do that like at home, like how I'm doing it now. So like sometimes I spend money on like hookah when I go out, but I be like, dang, I could be at home smoking my hookah because I got it at home. So now I be just trying to like throw little shindies, throw little parties, invite friends and family over and be on chill vibes. Like, and I had a success with like one party I threw, actually two, maybe three, a couple that I threw that was really fun. Girls' night, some nights with some friends that was lit. Yeah, and so like I be really wanting to travel and stuff like that. So I be trying to buy like, hold on, I'm trying to get my playlist together. Y'all, I like Boosie too, but I love, y'all know who gonna listen to some Kevin, cause I'm just play free no more. I ain't heard it in a minute. Old Migos, I like them too. She's a stripper, naked dancer. Me from in the first time I met Lil Mama, she was the one I had. Y'all, I'm a little ratchet too. Like, I love the South. Like, I love like hip hop, R&B, old school. Like, I just like Atlanta wave. Anybody that's really into music, the Atlanta wave is the wave. I feel like the West Coast, I like Tupac too. I like DDG, that's West Coast to me. I like YG. It's this dude named D. I saw an offer show that Cardi B and T.I. had, he was really good. I can't even think of his name, but his name is D. He's like a soulful, conscious artist. He's really good. Tap into him. If y'all know what I'm talking about, y'all know he good too. Y'all, I'm a little corny too. Like, when OMG Girls was out, I was on that too. Who else? Let's see, coming up in Atlanta. Who was all out when we was kids? Y'all, I don't know if people remember. Okay, so Rich Kids, Schoolie, Pee Wee Longway, Trouble, shoot, who's some people? Lady Rich Kids, y'all remember that song? It was like, oh my gosh, everybody was on it. I was on Travis, baby. I was on Travis Porter forever. 10th grade, I bumped Travis Porter like it was nothing. Can remember being on my best friend iPad, iPod. That's when the little mini iPod with the different colors was out. And I was on it heavy. So yeah, y'all, I'm not like a, I know a lot of people who say, a lot of people who do weed, don't really do the hookah. I'm not a big fan of THC, sweet like that. But people be networking and people be getting off on the whole, you know, weed, making it grow and stuff like that. I know it's really big in Cali. That's my next travel trip too. So I'm excited about it. The girl got some places I want to go. So let's see. Next year, out the country. Next year, Cali. Next year, Chicago, because I'm going to Chicago. That's already stamped. Chicago and going out the country is already really stamped. Cali, I'm gonna do Cali. I was watching an interview. I heard that, like, Cali is dangerous right now. I don't know what's going on, but I definitely want to go. Yeah, and I also want to be, like, bilingual. Y'all, I want to get into some more, want to learn different stuff. Because I do want to go to, y'all scooter. Dang, do y'all remember? I don't know. A lot of people, y'all remember Bloody J? Yeah. Rallo, like, I don't know. I'm a little hood. So I like all that type of stuff, y'all. So I don't know. So like, I like go-go music too. Going to school kind of up north. Kind of made me get into like the DMV grind vibes, like go-go music. I can't do it all the way because I'm more of a trap type of person, but some of that stuff be hitting. I'm into like, oh, y'all, somebody put me on to, recently somebody put me on to a girl named Coffee. I thought she was a dude, but a girl named Coffee. How do I go back? Y'all trying to figure out how I go back. A girl named Coffee put me on to that. I had, I was out and somebody put me on to Coffee. I like her. She's more, I like Cardi Black. I love Cardi Black. I saw Plaza in concert with my mama. I do a lot with my fam though, for real, for real. Yeah, it's easy. Ah, what's this song by Coffee that I like? I don't know. I was playing this hard. Dang, what's this song? I know she got a song called Toast. But dang, what's the other song? Is it Pressure? It's Pressure by Baju Banti with him in there. I like these vibes too, y'all. I love it. I be wanting to go to like, okay, so like I like little hood spots too in the city where it's like real low. I got some spots for real. If you like, if people come to the city, come to Atlanta, I got like some little hood spots you can go to. They're just straight chill. Like if you ain't really into, I'm not into the clubs, but if you into like the little lounges, chill, be with your friends, y'all my little spot. I love it. But I like spots like this where they play music like this too. They have some on the east side. So back, like, y'all, somebody used to be out. So back like when I was first coming out of college, the east side has this spot. It's like a little Jamaican spot. Dang, I can't even remember the name, but it's chill too. I actually went with my cousin one point. I don't even know. It's like on Memorial Drive or somewhere. It's real cool. Real, real subtle. Yeah, like some old spots, like some jamming spots. I have to get into this type of music, which is like, what is it? West Indie? I don't know. Caribbean vibes. That's what I say. I don't really know the name for it. So correct me if I'm wrong for people who are like West Indian or Caribbean. I don't know the term for this type of music. It's like go-go, stuff like that. But I like it too. It's cool. I wanna, y'all, they speak like broken English. A lot of people think I speak broken English because they be like, you're from Atlanta, and you don't really say, they say we say Atlanta. Like, you don't say the whole word. So. Y'all, it's a thing, like, when real ATLians, notice, like, if you from Atlanta and, I don't know, people be like, I could tell you from the inner city because people who, like, really not in the inner city sound different. I'd be like, what? When I was in school, there were people who, like, live, like, on the outskirts of the city, and they'd be like, you don't sound like Ashley. And then they would be like, your accent is more thicker. So, yeah. So, but yeah, I love music, y'all. So, back onto the wave into, like, the real estate talk. I want to hop into the real estate now because coins, baby, it's about getting to the bag. I want to learn how to, like, I'm trying to network where I put, like, where I'm trying to get my own building. And 2022, that's what I'm going to work for. About to network more, like I said before, to contribute to that type of success. Because my granddad always tell me, like, the most valuable thing that you can really own is a piece of land. And it's time to take what he said and make a buck, you know. Trying to build generational wealth for my family, for, you know, my future, and for myself. I have, like, a lot of connect that I can get into, and I don't use it. So that's my big way for 2022. Yeah, y'all. So, I don't know. I just wanted to come talk to y'all. Hookah is like my vibes. It, like, makes me real chill. I be low. I be talking a lot, but I be low. Like, when I got a hookah in my hand and I'm just vibing, like, no alcohol. Y'all haven't done alcohol probably since. Wait, it was probably like June, July, August, September, October, November, 7 months, 7 months. This weekend, I probably am gonna drink a little bit. Okay, let me not lie. My birthday, I took 2 shots with my line sister, because she was like, I know you turned off on it, but, like, you can still drink a little, so peer pressure. So, yes, I took 2, but I kind of been, taking a break from it, because y'all, had some episodes, you know? But your girl worked through it. I did. Progression has been made. Your baby is about to have 4. I be vibing, y'all. I like this YouTube thing. I can't even believe that I can get on here and talk for an entire 24 minutes. So, like, when I be seeing people on YouTube, and I used to be so nervous, super nervous, scared to do it in front of people, because I don't know what they may think, or, you know, just, like, stuff like that. Like, but I have to, like, get out my comfort zone and understand, like, this is something you love to do, regardless of what other people don't like to do. Like, you know, you can't be a type of person where, you know, you can't let what other people think about you, you know, dictate your life. And, you know, I'm beginning to grow. I absolutely, oh, shit. I absolutely love that how people can just, you know, explore and, I don't know, just be genuine and, like, down to earth. Like, It's just be cool vibes. Like, I really love it. Like, I don't be on too much now. I never was really on too much. I am observing. Like I said, I do talk a lot, but I do observe like other people's energy, and I used to like take it in and feel bad about myself sometimes, cause I be like, damn, am I doing too much? But I'm starting to understand, like, you know, you can't worry about that type of stuff, cause you know, you gotta make yourself happy, you know? So yeah. So yeah, y'all. The real estate classes are expensive. You do have to really come out your own pocket for it. So that's really why I kind of been hesitant. But I say, what I say is like, jump on it. Y'all, I jump on everything. I'm quick to do stuff, and I learned like when you do that, like, when you jump on stuff, know what it is to come after it. And I had to learn it like last year. Like, basically, I had started a business. I was really jumping on it, but I didn't know how to like market it. So now I'm taking that opportunity since it has produced. I'm trying to figure out like if to continue with it. I don't want to start something and not like finish it or push it through, but I want to be like a advocate of really gung ho for the products that I sell. So that's why like I was selling Fitbands, and I want to be healthy. You know, if I'm selling it, I need to be healthy. So I'm trying to push that, and so I've been working out. I haven't promoted as much on here. But I'm thankful that the Lord and that people, you know, have tapped into the health wave and want to be on it, and people have got on the page and want to buy. Like, that's a blessing. I didn't know that, like, you know, I kind of knew because, you know, the whole pandemic, tapping onto that wave, like, getting into something, you know, I'm thankful for that. Getting into something can produce, you know, can help you like get some money. So I'm glad I kind of took that step. I'm kind of happy I took this step, because it like made me become an entrepreneur. It kind of forced me to, because I'm out here saying this stuff and I have to be, you know, adamant on it. So yeah, I'm excited about it. So yeah, y'all, like, I want to step into the commercial side of things. Like, I want to own stuff. I don't want to just be talking about it. I want to really own it. So that is what the big news for me this year, not this year, this year's ending, but for the new year that's coming in onwards. So your girl gonna be grinding again. I won't make it a goal, but I know I'm just, you know, do it, get to the bag this year, because I want to be sitting on the tropical island and making money off of it. Eventually I don't want to work, you know. Eventually, no, okay, let me not say that. I do want to work. I believe in education. I believe in go to school. I wholeheartedly do. I feel like if people can't do it, you know, I do understand that there are other ways to make a form of income, but I believe in education. I want to push it out to the kids. I want to push it out to adults. So I'm going to always continue my education. Like, you know how they say people are like lifelong educators? Well, educators are lifelong educators, so that's what I am. Yeah, and so with me learning about real estate, it really pushes me to understand the value of purchasing something on your own, just like buying a house. So I think tapping into commercial business and buildings where people want to buy them, You know, people be wanting to buy these buildings. And if you actually own it, you can set your own prices. So, yes. That's kind of what I've been working on. So, these last few months has been inspirational to me going to, like, galas. Going to informative events that talks about those things kind of put me in an aspect to, like, put my money into it. So, you know, hopefully, God willing, he puts me in a place where I'm able to succeed. And, you know, if you believe in God and you trust the process that you're in, he'll make a way. And so, yeah, y'all, like, 21 has really brought me into that. But, yeah, like, hookah and music vibes. That's what we're talking about. What's your vibe now? So, I want to do more talks like this, hookah vibes. So, what y'all think? It be chill, like. Y'all, so, okay, some destination trips, because I'm talking about it too, I'm just talking to y'all, like, what's some destination trips? I've been seeing, like, travel groups and stuff like that. Like, there's this place called Seychelles. I don't even know if I'm saying it right, but I think it's in Africa. Beautiful. Like, traveling is, I think, one of the best things you could ever do, whether it's small or big. I love small trips. Reason why, because, like, you, when you away from home, it's just a vibe. Like, home will always be home, but when you go somewhere else and experience, like, what other states or other countries have, like, they have so much more to offer. A lot. And it's, like, just the experience. Let alone not even just the people you with, just like the experience you get to enjoy that other places have to offer you is beautiful. Like, I know, like, Mexico, Dominican Republic, Punta Cana, all of that is so beautiful. Like, outside of the United States, they have, like, the Seven Wonders, and they just have so much beautification inside their actual country. United States is beautiful too, but, like, these other countries have, like, I don't know, just, like, exotic stuff. So, yeah, y'all, this video getting long. I ain't gonna ramp no more, but I'm probably gonna end this. Y'all know some other music put me on to it. So, yeah, y'all, I love y'all. Yeah.